We are live. And we are attempting to do all sorts of different things today. We're trying to... I'm doing some testing to see if... world... if we can hold a signal for the mic and all the shenanigans and just everything. Get a hold of us online at jiggyjaguar.com. Let's talk about MyPillow. Yes, indeed. Our good friends over there at MyPillow. Go to MyPillow.com or 800-550-2037. Use the promo code J-I-G-G-Y and save up to 30% off down comforters with the promo code J-I-G-G-Y. Check it out today. We talked about the bathrobes. We've talked about all the different things. My Pillow literally makes everything you can think of. Weighted blankets, the whole nine yards. Go over to MyPillow.com or 800-550-2037. Promo code is J-I-G-G-Y. Thanks for listening to the big broadcast. Let's go to Larry Tracy. He is going to join us here in just a few moments. The incredible Larry Tracy. Your friend and mine, Larry Tracy.
Hello, Dave.
Hello, my friend. How are you? I appreciate it.
Are you good?
So, Larry, there is a lot going on. We've got Larry Tracy with us today, best-selling author. Of course, Bring Home the Bacon is the latest from Larry. And so, Larry, will Liz Cheney make a third party or try to run third party? Well, what are you hearing?
Well, yeah, I'm hearing that around here in Washington. I hope she does.
But you hope she does?
Yeah,
why is that?
Strange. The reason I hope so, James, is that she will attract never Trumpers who, if they'd never vote, so they'd vote for the Democrat. If they have an alternative, they won't vote for the Democrat, Kamala Harris or Biden, and surprise them of some votes on it. If it's a candidate other than Trump, which I hope it is, I hope it's something like someone like Governor DeSantis, then I don't think she'd get many votes. On it, that whether she's a candidate or she has someone else, she's dead politically right now. I mean, she wasn't going to win in Wyoming anyway. She's trailing the Republican opponent by many points, so she'll probably even drop out.
Yes,
so I think we've heard the last of Liz Cheney. But if she forms a third party, I think it's to the benefit of the Republican Party, not to the Democratic Party.
Larry Tracy with us today. He joins us live here on our big program. So, Larry, Biden is pressuring Israel. What are you hearing from some of your sources?
Well, I'll tell you, I just saw a Reuters report, James, and about 5 minutes ago, and there is a ceasefire to go into effect at 2 o'clock Friday morning, our time. So maybe the pressure worked. If Israel agrees to it, but the key is, will Hamas agree to it? That's the question. They'll probably still try to lob them in. But I find it disgraceful that we turn our back on our key ally, Israel, and who is furnishing the weapons and the missiles to Hamas? It's Iran. Well, why didn't he make a call over to Iran and say, why don't you stop doing that? Let's do it equal. But now he feels he can bully Israel. And Bernie Sanders, who is Jewish, it was all set to block a sale of $73 million into military supplies to Israel. Because keep in mind, Israel buys all of its stuff. We don't give military assistance to Israel. They buy it all. And so that helps U.S. business quite a bit. Maybe that's one of the things that the anti-business party of the Democrats don't like about it. But I think we're probably going to see tomorrow that there will be a ceasefire, although I would think some maverick groups of Hamas will probably fire a few missiles in there. And whether the Israelis respond or not, we'll have to see. But I think we are coming to the end of this particular element of the ongoing war.
So Larry Tracy is with us today. Bring Home the Bacon is the latest from him. We love Larry Tracy. And so Larry... 124 retired generals are being critical of Biden policies. Give me your take on this.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you, I was a little disturbed at it because, but again, every political campaign, we have a bunch of generals who will come out for the Republican, a bunch of generals who will come out for the Democrats, and I wish they'd all just shut up.
That's awesome.
But this particular group, it's a little unusual because it's not in the campaign. Now, of the 124 generals, I know a couple of them at distance, but one I know very well, Brigadier General Joe Stringham, and he's one of those that signed it. Joe and I were colonels in the Pentagon. He was with the Army staff. I was in the Secretary of Defense office, and we worked very closely together. He's a super soldier. I mean, there was, he commanded the 75th Ranger Regiment. If you remember the movie The Green Berets with John Wayne, this was based on a special forces element that Ranger Joe, as I called him, and he was known as Smokin' Joe in the Army. It was based on his unit. He's just had an absolutely superb record. I was delighted to see that he was promoted to Brigadier General, and I was sorry to see that he didn't go further than that. And he's one of those signatories on there. I thought him. I found Joe to be a very thoughtful person. He was like me. He was a Latin American area specialist. His area was Brazil, and he served there as well. But on balance, I think they're just concerned as much as anything what they see happening within the military, because within the military, there seems to be a real strong move, they say, against extremists. But the extremists seem to be Republicans and Trump supporters.
Yes.
I don't see anything about Black Lives Matter, and they are probably represented within the military. And that organization was formed by three women who call themselves Marxist trained, and they pulled in a lot of money from woke corporations that just wanted to do it as protection. So I'd like to say, if they're going to go against extremists, I would like to see them go against both sides. And we have this Air Force Lieutenant Colonel, you've seen that one, I think his name is Lohmeyer. He was relieved of command because of a book that he had written, which had been given complete approval by Defense Department when he wrote it. It was against what he conceived as the beginning of a Marxist move within the military.
Yes, yes.
Now, Lieutenant Colonel Lohmeyer may have to leave the Air Force, but don't feel sorry for him financially. He is going to be a very rich man because his book has now reached number one on the Amazon. So he'll make a lot of money. Maybe I should make some big statement like that and get my book on public
speaking. That's right. That's right.
There is a real concern that there's a move of, I guess we call it political correctness, taking place within the military, and I don't like to see that. But the generals, the 124 flag officers that signed that, are probably reacting to that, but they'll just basically exacerbate the situation as well. So I just wish when they retired, the generals would just shut up.
I think that's great. Well, Larry, before we let you go, how do we get your book and get involved with what you're doing, my friend?
Well, it's on Amazon. You just go in, and the easiest way to do it is to just type in my name, Larry.